Philippine shares stage a recovery ahead of the latest inflation print in the United States. Michelle Ong reports.
Asian stocks gained on Thursday as a rally in the world's largest tech stocks lifted global shares to record highs. Positive revenue figures from chip-making giant TSMC sparked more optimism over artificial intelligence, with Japanese stocks crossing new peaks. Regional stocks also tracking an overnight rally on Wall Street, where the S&P 500 and the tech-heavy Nasdaq closed at fresh highs. Traders now awaiting key CPI data out of the U.S., expected to signal easing price pressures, giving the Federal Reserve room to begin cutting rates. Here at home, Philippine shares supercharged, jumping nearly 2% to close above 6,600 for the first time in 1.5 months.
The expectations for the earnings are pretty good, and we might see a little bit of exceeding when it comes to utilities. I think electricity distribution looks pretty good given how hot summer has been. Yeah. Water as well are both connected to that. Property as well as the banking sector, we think will continue to either outperform, or because of the first quarter results, we are already seeing that certain analysts are increasing their target.
And finally, no immediate plans to list just yet for Cebu-based Topline Group of companies. What started in real estate has since expanded into fuel distribution and to ports with Pier 88 and tech automating other ports in Visayas. Topline Group President and CEO Eric Lim says, while growth has been robust at around 30% in the past years and expansion aggressive, it's not yet considering going public.
This might be a good opportunity for us to enter into the fuel market, which is fuel distribution. And this was like probably about 8 or 9 years ago. Mm-hmm. And right now, if you think about for the past few years, it was mainly a buy and sell thing. Mm-hmm. So buy low and sell high. And then as the years progressed, we're able to basically change the business model into different kinds of pricing, hedging or MOPS pricing. So right now, what we're doing now for Topline, our core business is actually, we're into liquid fuel distribution.
It was only last year when you went into the consumer-facing side with your first service station.
Yes, correct.
What's the plan there?
So as of now, we're expanding to 9 stations. But the good thing for this one is we're targeting a niche market. We're calling it light fuels service stations. And then we also have a different segment. It's called light fuels express stations. Mm-hmm. It's actually a smaller outfit from other bigger stations if you compare it, but we're more focused on the two-wheeler and the light vehicle market because we're thinking about serving the underserved markets, which is a niche market. Because for Metro Cebu, right now, based on the data, there are actually about 60% would be more of motorcycles registrations in the past, last year.
Michelle Long, ABS-CBN News.